I'm Dave Feinlieb, and we're here at the MindMinds conference, which is actually 17 conferences, as I understand it. So tell us a little about yourself.
Okay.
I understand you are an entrepreneur, and about the event.
Okay, well, I'll start by myself. Basically, I have been in the software industry for 20 years before I took this job, and I was active in several startups, lived in the States for a while. When I came back here, one of the opportunities I had was to start iMinds, which is both a research center and an incubator and accelerator of startups. That's we started iMinds, that was 7 years ago, and we've built it up during those years, and it's now become an organization that has quite a large ecosystem of partners here, both large and small companies.
Conference, please.
All 17 of them. So
yeah.
Basically, iMinds Conference started as a networking event for our partners. First edition was, I think, 300 people. And that was, again, 6 years ago. And it grew steadily until 2 years ago we decided to make it more of an international event and also come up with a new concept of putting different conferences that have slightly different angles but on related topics and that bring in a crowd of different people. So, for example, this year we are combining our own iMinds conference with conferences on a failed conference on entrepreneurship but also we have a youth media day where you have young students come in. We got a future media lab here going on about the future of printed press. So there's, and we got TEDx in Brussels, that's also linked to this whole basically 2 weeks of conferences and workshops that have people from media, internet, and technology come together.
So last night at dinner we heard some somewhat controversial thoughts on the future of media. Maybe you could spend just a moment on your own thoughts on where the industry is headed and you know, where some of the opportunities are for these entrepreneurs.
Yeah. So, because of the theme of the conference, which is digital media, we are, and the work we do there, we're smack in the middle of an ongoing discussion between technology companies and media companies, traditional media companies primarily, about how content is distributed, reproduced, and actually monetized. So yesterday was actually the CEO of one of the largest press groups, it's called the Press Group actually here in the Benelux, that has a billion turnover. At several newspapers and several channels. His claim is, you know, people are violating ownership, essentially, right now in the digital world, and that cannot continue if we are if we want to have the guarantee of quality content in the future. I think there is a point there. I don't think we can just have, you know, a free-for-all, so to speak, on the digital world. But I do think also that it's not black and white. Okay? So you don't want to stop innovation in new forms of repackaging content, etc. But more transparency in the value chain is needed. And we are only now getting to grips with what that implies. It will take a couple of years, in my opinion, to find a new equilibrium. Just like is happening, at least partially, in the music industry, where, you know, with iTunes, Spotify, there's new revenue models coming. That money flow back to the creators.
Great. So a lot of the readers of my column are U.S. readers, of course. What are some thoughts you have, having worked all around the world, for some of my U.S. colleagues?
Well, first of all, I really enjoyed working in the States. It was the 90s and the decade after that, and it's a unique place, specifically Silicon Valley, in terms of the opportunities you have there as an entrepreneur. And to a certain extent, the efforts we're doing here is not trying to reproduce Silicon Valley, but to at least take over some of the good parts of that model and good things in that model, and create a similar entrepreneurial culture and enthusiasm here. From the perspective of you know, having worked in the United States, I worked in two very different places, California and Dallas, Texas. And I think there's two kinds of Americans, basically, the ones who have a global look at the world, and the ones who are very inward looking. The U.S. is a big country, and you know, you can get you can spend your life there without really having to worry too much about the rest of the world. But what I think is happening, and this is a phenomenon that we see here at iMinds as well, is, you know, it's really, the world is globalizing.
Yeah.
Good ideas are coming from every potential angle, whether it's here or Shanghai or Africa.
Right.
And there's one good thing I'd like the Americans to do is to stay involved with the rest of the world.
Great. Well, Wim, thanks so much.
Thank
it's been
you.
A pleasure being at the conference and chatting with you.
Thank you.
All right.